Welcome to another presentation about the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. This presentation discusses glass deposits found in the Atacama Desert in Chile created by low-altitude explosions of comet fragments. A paper published in 2022 by Professor Peter Schultz and four co-authors describes twisted and folded silicate glasses up to 50 centimeters across, concentrated in certain areas across the Atacama Desert near the city of Pica in northern Chile. The glass was created by nearly simultaneous intense airbursts close to Earth's surface at the end of the Pleistocene epoch. The evidence includes mineral decompositions that require ultra-high temperatures, dynamic modes of emplacement for the glasses, and entrained meteoritic dust. Thousands of identical meteoritic grains trapped in these glasses show compositions and assemblages that resemble those found exclusively in comets and CI group primitive chondrites, which are a rare type of stony carbonaceous meteorites. Combined with the broad distribution of the glasses, the Pica glasses provide the first clear evidence for a cometary body or bodies exploding at a low altitude. This occurred soon after the arrival of proto-archaic hunter-gatherers and around the time of rapid climate change in the southern hemisphere. The map on the left shows the location of Pica, Chile, where the desert glass was found. The image on the right is the satellite image highlighting the same area. The satellite image shows the contrast of the brown arid desert and the green Amazon rainforest, which are separated by the Andes mountain range. This is a satellite image of the area around Pica, Chile, where the fused glass was found close to the Puquio de Nuñez. Puquio is the Spanish word for spring. 12 kilometers to the west of Pica, there is a large solar power farm. The publication by Schultz has examples of folded and twisted glass slabs showing contrasting textures that indicate the formation of the glass on a sedimentary surface with subsequent folding while still molten. The glasses contain numerous meteoritic fragments. Burnt organic soil at Puquio de Nuñez directly below and in contact with the glass sets a maximum age of 12,300 calendar years before the present at 95% confidence interval for the glasses. Younger ages of 11,500 and 11,100 years before the present came from non-carbonized roots that extended through a layer containing carbonized plants caused by the thermal event, and therefore post-date the glasses. The authors conclude that the dates for the Pica glasses coincide with the disappearance of quaternary megafauna in South America, an extinction that was more severe than that on any other continent. The authors do not claim a causal link, but they say that the timing is intriguing. This satellite image shows a closer look of the location of the fused glass site. Notice the large circular dark area about 1 kilometer south of the site. The circular area has a diameter of 700 meters. It is possible that the dark circular area is a remnant of the cometary firebolt that fused the glass. The circular feature near Puquio de Nuñez in Chile is reminiscent of the Iturraldic crater, which is a circular feature with a diameter of 8 kilometers in the Bolivian portion of the Amazon rainforest. The feature was first identified from Landsat satellite imagery in 1985 and was visited by researchers in 2002. Based on the presence of millions of glass beads, it has been hypothesized that the structure was created in the late Pleistocene between 30,000 and 11,000 years ago by the airburst of a non-impacting meteorite similar to the Tunguska event in 1908. The radar topography image on the left shows the Iturraldic crater very clearly, whereas the feature is almost invisible in the satellite image because it is covered by dense jungle. A paper presented at the Lunar and Planetary Science Conference in 2013 said that the measurements and analysis provide initial evidence supporting the hypothesis that the Iturraldis structure may have formed during an explosion or airburst as a result of atmospheric impact by a low-density extraterrestrial body. For an airburst to have occurred, the extraterrestrial body must have been small enough and or possess low enough density, such as porous ice or stone, which made it unable to penetrate the atmosphere and reach the Earth's surface to form a classical impact crater. The Iturraldi crater and the Puquio de Nuñez desert glass are separated by 900 kilometers. It is possible that these features were formed contemporaneously by the explosion of pieces of a disintegrating comet. A paper published in 2020 reported melt glass, nanodiamonds, microspherules, and charcoal from another cosmic impact at Abu Huraira in Syria at the onset of the Younger Dryas 12,800 years ago. Many scientists dispute that extraterrestrial impacts were the cause of the extinctions in North and South America. Some still propose that overhunting by the humans who colonized America and climate change caused the extinctions. However, a large platinum anomaly and a wide field of impact microspherals provide strong evidence that the Earth was hit by an extraterrestrial object 12,900 years ago. The secondary impacts of glacier ice chunks ejected by the extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet could have created the Carolina Bays and the Nebraska rainwater basins and simultaneously killed the megafauna in a large area from the Rocky Mountains to the east coast of the United States. The site of the impact in North America has not been found, but the orientations of the basins in Nebraska and the Carolina Bays in the east coast converge by the Great Lakes. The elliptical geometry and the orientation toward a common point are clues about the location of the extraterrestrial impact, but these geological features are attributed to wind and water mechanisms in mainstream publications. A paper published in 2019 found a sedimentary record in southern Chile supporting the hypothesis that a cosmic impact triggered by a mass burning, climate change, and megafaunal extinctions 12,800 years ago. The paper reports on a sedimentary sequence at Pilauco, Chile, that exhibits peak Younger Dryas boundary concentrations of platinum, gold, high-temperature iron, and chromium-rich spherules, and native iron particles rarely found in nature. A major peak in charcoal abundance marks an intense biomass burning episode, synchronous with dramatic changes in vegetation, seasonality in precipitation, and warmer conditions. The fossil record in southern Chile indicates a massive extinction at the Younger Dryas boundary. The sudden disappearance of megafaunal remains and dung fungi in the Younger Dryas boundary layer at Pilauco correlates with megafaunal extinction across the Americas, so it is plausible that the Earth was hit by multiple fragments of a disintegrating comet. Humans were not spared by the cosmic catastrophe. The stress of surviving the Younger Dryas is recorded as a human Y chromosome bottleneck at the end of the Pleistocene epoch. The Y chromosome is responsible for the development of male reproductive organs, and it is passed only from father to son. The paper by Carmen, with 100 authors, proposes that the bottleneck was caused by a global change in culture. However, the Y chromosome diversity started to decrease in all regions of the world exactly at the Younger Dryas boundary about 12,900 years ago, and it is not likely that similar cultural changes would have occurred simultaneously in regions widely separated by oceans, deserts, mountains, and jungles. The mitochondrial DNA, which is passed from a mother to her offspring, indicates that the worldwide human population continued to increase in spite of the reduction of male-to-female ratio. A paper published by Ralph Catalano and two co-authors in 2008 concluded that ambient temperature affects the characteristics of human populations by influencing who survives gestation. The human Y chromosome bottleneck could have been triggered by the colder climate of the Younger Dryas cooling event. A paper published in 2020 reported the discovery of remains of two prehistoric hunters at an early Holocene site in highland Peru, including the 9,000-year-old remains of a young woman buried with a well-stocked big-game hunting toolkit. Her burial included a comprehensive array of hunting and animal processing tools that support her hunter status, including stone projectile points for killing large animals, a knife and flakes of rock for removing internal organs, and tools for scraping and tanning hides. The authors concluded that between 30% and 50% of late Pleistocene and early Holocene big game hunters in the Americas may have been women. The active participation of women in hunting 9,000 years ago is consistent with the high ratio of women to men during the Y chromosome bottleneck. Evidence is slowly accumulating in support of the hypothesis that 12,900 years ago, the Earth crossed a meteorite stream formed from a comet that disintegrated during its orbit around the Sun. The impacts and airbursts in the northern and southern hemispheres caused megafaunal extinctions and triggered a global cooling event called the Younger Dryas. Even though humans have witnessed the Tunguska airburst in 1908 and the Chelyabinsk airburst in 2013, mainstream scientists are reluctant to accept the idea that one or more deadly extraterrestrial impacts happened 12,900 years ago. Many publications still attribute the extinction of the megafauna to human overhunting and to climate change. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. The Carolina Bays should not be neglected. asked your geology professors to discuss the Carolina Bays because they are the most prevalent geological structures in the Atlantic coastal plain. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.